Hello learners, today we will start 5th chapter of 8th class, that is coal and petroleum. Coal and petroleum, we use various materials for our basic needs. Some of them are found in nature and some have been made by humans' efforts. So we all know that we use n number of things daily. Some of them are naturally made, they are given by nature, and some of them are artificial or man-made. This is a list of natural and man-made material like air, soil, water, sunlight, CNG, LPG, coal, petroleum, fruits, minerals. All these are natural material. They are obtained from the nature and the natural sources. Whereas, on the other hand, table, chair, car, bus, TV, plastic, rubber, bed, food, blackboard, all are man-made material and they are made artificially by the man. Now, we were talking about some of the resources, or we can say natural resources. Resource means treasure or the gift given by the nature. So, natural resources are the gifts, or we can say the assets or the treasure given by nature for our survival. Now, this natural resources can be further divided into inexhaustible and exhaustible natural resources. Exhaustible will be further divided into two categories, renewable and non-renewable. So, you have to consider this flowchart and you have to make your concept very clear that natural resources are the gifts or the assets given by nature for our survival, for our existence. Some of these natural resources can be categorized as inexhaustible and some of them are exhaustible. If you see inexhaustible, these resources are present in unlimited quantity in nature and are not likely to be exhausted by the human activities, for example, sunlight and air. But if you see exhaustible means the amount of these resources, natural resources in nature is limited. They can be exhausted. They can be exhausted by human activities. Exhausted means they can be used up. They can be finished by the human activities. Example can be forest, wildlife, minerals and fossil fuels like coal, petroleum and natural gas. So, we will study this classification of natural resource in detail. Now, this slide will clearly give you the definitions and examples and how all the natural resources are interrelated. Now, see, natural resources can be divided into inexhaustible natural resource and exhaustible. This is first division. Okay, so inexhaustible natural resource means they are present in unlimited quantity. They are not exhaustible. They can be used. They will be present forever. They have got unlimited quantity. For example, sunlight and air. If you see exhaustible natural resource, so they are present in limited quantity, like forest, wildlife, minerals, coal and petroleum. So, both of them are natural resources given by nature for our survival, for our betterment. But unfortunately, we don't use them judiciously and carefully. And then, if in case we will not use them judiciously and carefully or mindfully, then one day we will have to suffer a lot. So, it's a kind request for all that we have to realize our duty, we have to realize our responsibility. If we know and we are studying that exhaustible natural resources, they have got limited quantity, so we have to save them. We have to use them judiciously and carefully so that it's not that we only will be capable of using them, but next generation or the coming generations will also be capable of utilizing them. And even in case of our this one, inexhaustible natural resources, it does not mean that they are present in unlimited quantity like sunlight or air. So they are present in unlimited quantity, so we are going to waste them. We have to use them properly, and we have to take a good care of all these natural resources. Okay, so this is a kind of a moral value or a moral responsibility as a good citizen. Now, further, we can divide exhaustible natural resources into renewable and non-renewable natural resource. Renewable natural resource, as you can see in the name itself, if you bifurcate or if you split the name, renewable. Re means again, new. You can make them new again. They are renewable. Renewable. You have to split the word renewable. They can be renewed again. They can be regenerated through various natural cycles. For example, soil, forest, wildlife. They can, although they are exhaustible, but yes, they can be renewed. When we talk about soil, we are talking about basically the top layer of the soil, and that is rich in minerals or the humus, and it takes time to make the top soil. So that is very important, fertile, and it has got all the minerals important for the plant, for the growth of the plant. And we know all plants are producers, and rest all in the food chain are consumers. Directly and indirectly, all of them are dependent on plants only. So for plants, topsoil is important, and for us, plants are very important. So soil is also a renewable, exhaustible natural resource. If you see non-renewable, exhaustible natural resource, so they cannot be replenished. They cannot be replenished themselves by recycling and replacement. Once they are finished forever. Because if you see in case of fossil fuels shown here, so we have got three fossil fuel: coal, petroleum and natural gas. Coal, petroleum and natural gas. These are the three fossil fuels, and fuels are very important for us in our day-to-day activities. So we should use them properly and carefully. Okay, and minerals are also there, which are present in rocks, like gold, silver. All these are the minerals which are present in rocks. So they are non-renewable. Why non-renewable? Why we can't renew them? Because it is a time-consuming process. It takes millions of years for such fossil fuels and minerals to be formed. So this is all about natural resource. Thank you. Keep revising and watch the videos carefully.